All Georgia Canuck. It's a roundup for the hunts from last weekend and a couple of times this week. Thanks to my lovely wife letting me go and me getting my chores done. So let's start with the money. Two toonies, $4. Three loonies, $3. $3.50 in quarters. $2.30 in dimes, 70 cent in nickels, 13 cent in 1960s, 49 cent in 70s, 61 cent in 80s, and $1.24 in modern garrot. Two gaming tokens from arcades. Ones really are done in. One American quarter, two American dimes, 23 cent in American stinking Lincolns, as they call them. One pointer tip, it's not an arrowhead or it's too light. A tiny little rusted lock, three hole keys, two quarter keys, lead fishing weight. This is a big, heavy number 4, but it's fairly old. It's probably from the 40s or 50s, maybe the 60s. I have no idea what these are. They're not magnetic. They were all in the same hole. If anybody knows, let me know. This actually rang up on the metal detector. I think it's coal, or is it coke? Somebody out there let me know, but yeah, it rang up in the 60s on the detector. We got I believe a knockoff Malaysia car. I don't think it's Hot Wheels. Bottom piece to a car. Wings off an airplane. Metal soldier. He's hollow on the inside. Just like World War I from his helmet. Dog tag with the name and phone number, Surrey, on it. Bottle opener with a clip to attach it to your keychain or your belt. Two pieces of an old 50s cap pistol. That's the only two pieces I could find. Jamaica, no problem. Sticker tag thing. Back off an old watch. Cow's head cowboy clip, and this chain was attached to it. Some junk flower jewelry. This gave me a really good scare. It's heavy. It's a cufflink. There's the cufflink piece there. When it came out of the ground, I thought I had a nitro moment there. I thought I had some gold, but as you can see, it's crap. Definitely crap. Anyway, junk jewelry. George 6, 1940 penny, Elizabeth 53, 59, 61, 362s and 164, 1951 D wheat, 1956 D wheat, and 1959 D wheat. The wheat for Denver, I guess. So, I cleaned up the St. Christopher's medal, and it shined up pretty good on the front. The back's still a little stained, but it does look like it's silver now. It's the ring I found in the curb. Kid's ring, and just to let you see the size, you see how the size of the St. Christopher's medal, and it'll fit inside of it barely. And that's just to give you a size differential, because other people have been posting saying, oh man, that's a fat ring. Well, for kid's ring, yeah, it's a fat ring, but it's still a kid's ring. The other two cleaned up quite nicely. and they are marked. But anyway, that's it for this week. Hopefully Sunday I'll get out again with Marty Moose and see what we can find. I've got a place that's a park now. It used to be farmland, I think. It's huge trees on it, so if he wants to go, we're going to run up there. If not, we'll go someplace else. But anyway, good luck and happy hunting all. And as Jed Peacehaven says, it's out there, fellas. Just go get it. But my God, my back hurts from digging all these bennies. Later, all.